Hello guys, welcome to another problem in the series of coding. Today we are going to discuss the problem of walls coloring, which is Geeks for Geeks problem of the day. So there is a row of n walls in Geeksland. The king of Geeksland ordered Alexa to color all the walls on the occasion of New Year. Alexa can color each wall with either pink, black or yellow. The cost associated with coloring each wall with a particular color is represented by 2D array colors of size n cross 3, where colors of i0, colors of i1 and colors of i2 is the cost of painting ith wall with colors pink, black and yellow respectively. You need to find the minimum cost to color all the walls such that no two adjacent walls have the same color. So let's take an example. So we have three walls in this particular example. First wall, second wall and third wall. And we have three given colors always: pink, black and yellow. So one way of painting the walls is I paint the first wall as pink, second wall as yellow, third wall as black. So in this case, my cost will be 14 for the first wall, 5 for the second wall and 3 for the third wall. So the total cost will be 14 plus 5, 19, 19 plus 3, 22. Now this is a valid way to color the walls because no color is repeated on adjacent walls. What is not a valid way? For example, I cannot paint two adjacent walls as pink. So this way is not valid, right? For example, PPY. This is not a valid way because pink is getting repeated on two adjacent walls. So whenever we have two adjacent walls with the same color, that is not going to be valid. If I take another example, yellow, black, black, this is also not valid because black is getting repeated on two adjacent walls. But I can have something like black, yellow, pink, something like this, or black, yellow, black again. This is fine because black is not repeated on adjacent walls, right? So this is also acceptable. If I see this case, first wall is black, it will be 2, second wall is yellow, it will be 5, third wall is black, it will be 3. 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2 is 10. In fact, in this case, 10 will be the answer, 10 will be the minimum number of colors score that we can get. So how do we solve this question? So we need to consider that first, whenever we are painting a wall, we need to store the color of it so that next time we know we should not use it in the next adjacent wall. So let's take an example. Let's start for the first wall, right? So first wall can be painted either pink, blue or yellow. All the three cases are valid because for the first wall we have no limiting condition. There is no previous wall. So first wall can be painted with either pink, blue, pink, black or yellow. So there are three cases, right? Case 1 is I paint the first wall as pink. Case 2 is I paint the first wall as black. Case 3 is I paint the first wall as yellow. Now let's proceed further. If I go on to follow case 1, right? If first wall is painted as pink, now the second wall cannot be painted as pink, okay? So I need to make a note that my previous wall was pink. So if the previous color was pink, let me represent pink with 0, black with 1 and yellow with 2. So if my previous value was 0, this next wall cannot have 0. Next wall can be black or next wall can be yellow. So if the previous is 0, the current values can be 1 or 2. Okay, so I will have to delve in both of the cases. So if I paint the second wall as black, the cost will be 14. If I paint the second wall as yellow, the cost will be 5. Okay, we are seeing from the second row. Now I can continue further. Here again I will have two cases. If I paint the second wall as black, right, then the third wall cannot be painted as black. What can the third wall be? Third wall can be anything apart from black. So third wall can be pink or third wall can be yellow. It cannot be black because black was the previous color. So I can take either pink or I can take yellow. If I take it as pink, I will get 14. If I take this as yellow, I will get 10, right? Okay, so this is one way, but there are many ways. So we will have to delve into all the cases to see the answer. So let us delve here into the next case. So let's continue this case. First wall was pink, second wall was yellow. Now third wall cannot be yellow. It can be pink or black. So if it is pink, it is 0. If it is black, it is 1. So pink is 14. And black is 3, right? We can see from the last row. Okay, now let us go to these cases. These cases are also pending, right? So let us try to complete the recursive tree so that we have clarity. So if the first wall was painted black, second wall can be pink or yellow. So if second wall is pink, it will be 11. If second wall is yellow, it will be 5, right? Now again, in both of these, we have two further cases. So let me try to write it. If the second wall is pink, the third wall can be black or yellow. So if the third wall is black, the cost is 3. If the third wall is yellow, cost is 2. Now let us continue here. In this case, the second wall was yellow. So the third wall can be pink or it can be black. If it is pink, the cost is 14. If it is black, the cost is 3. Okay. Now we have one more case. So let us go to this case. In this case, the first wall was yellow. So now the second wall can be pink or it can be black. So if it is pink, it will be 11. If it is black, it will be 14, right? And we have further cases. Here, two more cases because we need to paint the third wall also. So if the second wall was pink, the third wall can be black or yellow. Black is 1, yellow is 2. So black is represented by score 3 and yellow will be cost of 10. Okay, let's proceed. We have two more cases. So here we have two more cases. If the second wall is black, then the third wall can be pink or the third wall can be yellow. So if it is pink, it will be 14. If it is yellow, it will be 3, right? So we can see we have lot of cases. Now let us try to calculate. If we try to calculate each case, right? Brute force, for example, this will be one case. In this case, you can see the answer is 14 plus 14 plus 14, which is 42. In this case, the answer is 14 plus 14 plus 10, which is 38. In this case, the answer is 14 plus 5 plus 14, 33. In this case, the answer is 14 plus 5 plus 3, 22. Right? Like this, we can try to calculate answer for each case, right? We will have to go to each cases, all the cases like this, and we will have to calculate the answer. So this is the brute force way, right? Now how do we actually solve it? Is you can see that many calls are repeating, right? Here we can notice that many calls will be repeating. For example, this call, right? You can see this call is the same as this call. These two calls are exactly similar. So once if I calculate the answer, right, I can just reuse the same answer. So here we can memoize and we can save time. So we will write the recursive code first, then we will optimize it by using memoization and we can save time, right? Because you can see many calls are repeating. For example, this call is also exactly same as this call, right? These two calls are just exactly same. So once we find the answer for this one, we can just store the answer and we will not calculate the values again. Okay, but for now, let's just solve it, right? Let us see how we will see the answer. So when we reach this, this is the base condition, right? So we will take the minimum. So here the answer is 14, right? For the last value, which is the base condition, third wall for painting with pink color, the value is 14. Here the value is 10. Now this call will take minimum of these values, right? So minimum of 14 and 10 will be 10. So 10 will be taken. Now 10 plus 14 is 24. So 24 will be passed on here. From this side, let's calculate what will be the answer. Here minimum of 3 and 14 will be taken. This resolves to 14. This resolves to 3. So minimum will be taken. So you will take 3, right? And 3 plus 5 is 8. So you will pass 8 to your parent call. Now between 24 and 8, you will choose 8, and 8 plus 14 will be equal to 22. So 22 will be passed. So if you choose the first wall as pink, second wall as yellow and third wall as black, this will be the case which will give minimum from this side. But we have to calculate like this for all the cases, right? So let us see this case. This will resolve to 3. This is 10. Minimum of 3 and 10 is 3. So we will take 3. 3 plus 11 is 14. So here we will pass 14 to the parent call. From this side, we will take minimum of 14 and 3, which is again 3. 3 plus 5 is 8. So we will pass 8 here. Now minimum of 14 and 8 is 8. 8 plus 2 will be 10. So 10 will be passed from this side. Okay. Like this, let us calculate for this side also. So from this side, minimum of 13 and 10 will be 10. And 10 plus 11 is 21. So 21 will be passed here. Here 14 and 3 minimum is 3. 3 plus 14 is 17. So 17 will be passed here. Now minimum of 17 and 21 is 17. 17 plus 11 is 28. So 28 will be passed here. So out of these 3, the minimum value is 10. So 10 will be taken as the answer. Okay. So let us try to code it and then it will be clear. Okay. So first let's write the simple recursive code. So there will be a function that I will call. I will pass colors in that function. I will pass n in that function. And I will pass I for the corresponding index, right? And I also need the color of the previous wall, right? For example, if the previous wall was 0, right? So my current wall can be only 1 or 2. If my previous wall was 1, my current can be only 0 or 2. If my previous is 2, my current can be only 0 or 1, right? So depending on the previous values, we will write 3 cases. So let us write a function. And finally, the answer the function returns, we will return that as the answer. Okay. So let us write this recursive function first, which is going to take 4 parameters, colors, n, I representing the index, and a previous value which will represent the color we chose last time. Okay, so let us see. See, if the previous is equal to 0, right? If the previous color was 0, then what will happen? Now you can only take color 1 or 2 next time. Okay. So if the previous is equal to 1, okay, that means you can only take colors 0 or 2. If the previous is equal to 2, you can only take colors 0 or 1, because you cannot have two walls adjacent with the same color. Okay. So let us write it like this. If the previous does not equal to 0, that means if the previous color was not pink, right? 0 represents pink. Then I can take pink in this case. So if the previous was not pink, then I can take pink here. So I will take pink. So colors of I of 0. This represents, I am taking pink for the current wall. Okay. Pink is the 0th index. So let me write here. 0 was pink, 1 was black, and 2 was yellow. Okay. It doesn't matter. 0, 1, 2 is what is important. Okay. So if the previous is not 0, then I can take 0th color at this step. And I will call the recursive function for the remaining part. So when I call the recursive function, now notice carefully, when I call the recursive function, already I have selected the value for ith wall. So I will call the function for the remaining next walls. So I will change I to I plus 1. Already I have selected the color for ith wall and I am going to call for I plus 1. Now the previous I will mark as 0. So this will signify next time, see, next time in the next call what will happen? If I have marked this wall as 0, so next time previous value will become 0. So then I will not select pink next time, because here I am marking the previous as 0. Okay. So like this I can take care. So now if previous does not equal to 1, that is the previous wall was not black, then I can take this wall as black. So I will take colors of I1, which is black, and I will call the remaining function to solve for the remaining walls. So I will pass the previous as 1. So this will signify next time I should not choose 1. If I am choosing 1 here, next time I will hit this condition, right? So I will not go into this case next time. Okay, because I am choosing 1 here, so for the next wall this condition will be taken care that previous will be 1 next time. If I go into this case, next time previous will be 1. So 1 not equal to 1, this value will be false. So we will not go into this condition, right? So next time I will not again choose black. Okay, now let us go to the last condition. If previous not equal to 2, then I can choose this. So colors of I2, which will be yellow color. And I can call the function for the remaining part. I plus 1 and 2. Okay, now these are 3 cases. So let me write this as case 1. Let me write this as, or I can write it as pink. Okay, let me call it first color as pink, second one as black, and third is yellow. So if I am taking pink at the ith index, I will call it as pink. Okay, so I will declare first these values as maximum value, int max. Now let me take this as black also as int max and yellow also as int max initially. Okay. Now I can return minimum of these 3 values. So return minimum of pink, black and yellow. Okay, now I also need to write the base condition. So what is the base condition? If just I is equal to colors dot size. So if I am done with all the walls and I have reached the last index, which is out of bounds, then in that case I can just return 0, right? There is no wall, so no color will get added. Okay, so this should be like the recursive function call, but this will not pass the test cases, right? Because it will be of exponential time complexity. So we need to memoize the solution, because many calls will be repeating again and again, right? So what is changing in each function call? I is changing and previous is changing. So we need to memoize using I and previous. So let me declare a DP matrix. So vector int DP. Okay. And initially I can give the value of DP. Let's say I give the value of DP as -1. Okay. So if DP of I and previous does not equal to -1, then I can return DP of I previous. So it is just simple memoization that I am doing. If the value is already stored, then I will just use that value. I will not go into these calls and I will not calculate it again. I will just return directly from here. If the value is not already calculated, then I will calculate it here and cache it here. So I am storing the value here. So DP of I previous will be calculated here and that will be returned. Okay. Now there is just one thing. First, I need to resize my DP vector. So let me resize. So it will be a 2D matrix. So first parameter in the DP vector is representing I for index. So the size I can take as n, right? So that it will cover all the walls. Now the second parameter that I can take will be, so I need to represent three colors, 0, 1, 2. Okay. So let me take it of size 4 and let me fill -1 initially everywhere. Now first time when I'm using previous, right, first time for the first wall there is no previous, there is no wall that exists, so all the three conditions should be valid for the first wall. So I should give a value of previous, something which is not 0, not 1, not 2, right? All the three conditions should be valid, so I can give something like 3 here. So first time when I see the conditions, all the three cases will be executed. Okay. So I think something like this should work. Let me try to run and see if it is going to work. I was not declared in this scope. So here I was not declared. I will start from 0. Okay. So initially from the main function, I can give the value of I as 0. Okay, it's working fine. Let me submit the code and see if it will work for all the test cases. Yes, it's working. Thank you for being patient and listening.